Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. Today I'm continuing with the series of videos I'm recording about the Google Vertex AI. We will cover the section language model and we will look at the which possibilities we have for prompting, chat and translation in this tool. Let me show. So I assume that you have already created your access to Google Cloud. And you have activated the APIs of Vertex AI, and you have as well created the service account, which allows you to code in your machine locally and access to the APIs. All this stuff is already posted on the channel: how to create the account, how to create the service account, and in general, all this stuff. We will not cover it here. We will just go through the different options we have on the language sections. We already covered the multimodal and create an application which interact with the Gemini 1.5 Pro and also deploy an endpoint. So you also can take a look. This is going to be quite similar. The only difference here is that these models are specialized in language. We will cover prompting, we will cover conversational chatbots and translate. Also, I'm finishing fine-tuning a model for language classification. But I will post it in a second video because it's not, it's going to be very long and I don't want to do very very extensive video where it's very difficult to cover. So again, once you have access, you can go to the I had the now Vertex AI pinned to my favorite, but it's not. You can go to artificial intelligence section, and there you had Vertex AI. Once you get here, you go to the dashboard. You enter into the dashboard directly. It's just the first time that you are interacting with Vertex AI. You just activate it. You will, or you just create your account. You will need to activate the APIs. We are going to prepare as usual a notebook that later on I will post to the repository. So you want to interact cover later on the notebook in your local environment, you will need to have the service account and all this stuff already created. Again, it's everything on the channel for those that just view this series first time. And then on, we will not cover it here. Just take a look to the video. There is one specifically how to create the service account. To create the Google Cloud account is also a video how to do it. Then we go directly to that. So what we have here in the language section, you see here in the Vertex AI Studio, you can interact with the models using the UI that you have here. You have three main sections: text the prompt generation, typical completions in OpenAI for those that are familiar with ChatGPT or with the OpenAI models. Here, the chat section, which they say that ChatGPT you will see now and translate, which allow us to convert translate language between different languages. You also had here the section to fine-tune a model. Again, I will cover this in a separate video. I already had the stuff done, but I prefer to review this in a separate video to go in deep how to do it and how to later deploy the model to an endpoint. And also how to build the dataset, etc., which is again is a little bit long content, and then better to split it into separate videos. So here as well, you have plenty of examples that you can use for your particular use case. Very well documented. And then on, I'm completely sure that whatever you need is somehow is they are very simple examples. You will see that working with code in Vertex AI with these examples are pretty similar, all of them. They just simply interacting with the model, preparing the prompt, sending an answer, a question to the model, and waiting for an answer. But well, you can see here, you can get at least some ideas of how to begin in solving one of whatever, again, whatever problem that you may have, either prompting or completion or chat. You have an example here. Again, very well documented. There is also some tutorials that you can follow in the platform. Very very simple tutorials, maximum 20 minutes, and this is every topic that you may need are covered here, and then on very well explained as well. Very simple. I'm really, how to say, happy, surprised of how they improved this in just 4 months. The first time I make a video, it was 4 months ago, about when they released Gemini, the version 0.0.1, Gemini Pro 1.0, and then on the still it was, how to say, a little bit primitive, no? What we can do, and also the outputs of the version 0.0.1 was a little bit disappointing, not very good, the answers, especially on the COT and the chain of through prompting with trying to solve mathematical and this kind of questions that you need to do to use a rational or an abstract the solution of the problem, and then in there that the answers were a little bit poor, and in some cases even wrong. Today I did exactly the same that 4 months ago, and the outputs are really, really much better. Just with the version 0.0.2 of the Gemini Pro, we didn't even use, like, in the multimodal videos that we use Gemini 1.5, the preview version. Here, just we use the latest stable version of the version 1, the 0.0.2, and the outputs are really, really good. So what we had here, we had the conventional again, the prompting, text prompt, and later we will cover some examples. But for those that are familiar with OpenAI or with Claude, Anthropic models, this is exactly the same. I'm not going to, well, we can discuss the available models you have here. You have the all ones, Bison or PaLM 2. There is on PaLM 2, the series PaLM 2 is for text generation. The Bison are more specific for code generation. But well, the recommendable are Gemini, obviously. They are the new released models. We will use the version 0.0.2, which again, in comparison with the 0.0.1, is much, much better. So same price at the same time. So be careful as well, or take a look in which area is more convenient for you, just case, especially if you are using data that you had saved in a bucket. Depending where you had the bucket, is quite important as well to choose the right region in order to avoid extra cost for data cross-bordering. So typical attributes, typical parameters, temperature, output tokens, and safety options. Here, this coverage as well. This is now common among all the models in Vertex AI. They have four categories. You can decide block. So three levels. If you do it programmatically, you can as well remove the control you want. No control in one of these four specific categories. We will cover it later. And it's not this low, medium, high. It's strict control, medium control, low control. We have four categories: hate, dangerous, sexuality, explicit, and harassment. And then again, this is working across any video, any model that we have on Google in Vertex AI. So later as well, we have top key parameters. Okay, it's quite conventional in terms of what is possible to configure. It's, again, you are familiar with OpenAI or Claude, is pretty much the same. Like we didn't say, you can set up here the stop sequence. If you want to include, for example, when the model is generating, and the model generate specific combination of words, stop to generate more text. No? What more is interesting here, you had these two options, freeform, that is a conventional prompt that you prepare, doesn't mind that you can, it can be zero short prompt or can be few short prompting, it's up to you, you have to write it, everything, and then on you submit and you get an answer. If you do it in the structured, this is quite more organized, you can do the same, exactly the same that in the freeform, but here you had the chance to organize your examples with an input as an output. You here write the context of the prompt, and here again the samples, input and output. You can import it. It has to be something similar to here. How is the you can create it offline, no? In a Jupyter notebook or whatever, in a file, you generate inputs and outputs, you can import it later using the import. Quite convenient there. You can also here introduce different columns. For example, when you had in COT prompting, you had an input or a question, you had an output with an answer, you also have the rationale, you have also probably the type, you can introduce different columns to identify the different parts of the prompt. This is fully configured. If you had the information prepared beforehand, probably you have some example, this is much more convenient because it gives you more, at least it's quite more organized way to provide information to the model. No? If not, you can do again, you can do the same here on the prompt, you just write the prompt exactly as we did it before, it's just free writing, and you organize the prompt as you wish. The model is going to work the same, but in my opinion, structured will give you a more structured way to prepare your prompt and send it to the model. Anytime you can save your model, your prompts. Later I will show you where they are saved. And every time you also get the code that is generated. It's not perfect. Sometimes even there is some small mistakes that you need to fix it. But well, it gives you at least a reference how to use the library. How to do this login is interactive login. You need to login with an account that is registered in Google Cloud. In the notebooks I will post later, as usually I'm doing with the service account, which is especially if you are developing an application, is much more convenient because some scenarios, some environments you cannot do interactive login, and then only if you are working in a Docker, it's impossible to do an interactive login because the application needs to authenticate itself without human intervention. In this case, you are working with a notebook, you can do also in the notebook use this interactive login, but again, I prefer when if I patch you something. To have this ready to be used in just to translate it, the code directly to a VS Code, for example, or even to a Docker and just work with that. No? In that way, I prefer to show you how to do it with a service account, which is more flexible in terms of being working the code in any practically in any environment. But in any case, you have here the example. You can also save with cool directly with an HTTP request how to interact with the API, and you have examples in Java, Node, and Python. I used to work, well, I work in Python, the rest I didn't test it so far. And well, that's all. Again, you have here text and code prompt. Code again is you will be working with the code vision models and the text unicorn, different variants of the specialized models. In you can also use the Gemini, but well, those are specialized in code generation. I make some example here. Let me show you. Here using the chat vision 2, I just ask I give assistant message, I make a question to create a function, to generate to extract text for a PDF which contain image, and then I think it will work, but in my opinion, this code, I need to test it, but in my opinion, this code is not going to extract the text from images. It will extract the text from the PDF. That's I'm practically sure that it will be done, but not from the images. You probably know that the PDF, it can come from a scan. You scan a document and you generate a PDF. And then on what you have inside is just a container. The PDF is a container which contains essentially a JPEG per page, and the rest is just some metadata which tells you that every page in the PDF is pointing to an image. And when you have, for example, when you generate a PDF from a Word document in Microsoft Windows or in MS Office, this PDF is completely different in terms of the structure. They are both PDFs, but the second one, the one that you generate from Microsoft Word, it contains the text. The text is part of the metadata. It's a structure, semi-structured format inside the PDF, and you can analyze and extract completely exactly the text that you have inside. Again, when you scan it, it's different. It's a PDF as well, but inside the document is very different. So this code that the Gemini or ChatBison generate, it may work again for a conventional PDF. This that you generate from a Word document in Microsoft Word, but I'm almost 100% sure that it will not work with an scanned document. I will test it and later I will write the output of this test in the video description. Let's move. Okay, this chat, exactly this for those that are familiar with ChatGPT, which is quite similar, similar interface to the prompt one, similar, exactly the same options. You can interact with Pro, the 1.5 Pro. This we will see later on the examples. Take a look later on at your convenience and start to interact a little bit with there. But again, this is a typical conversational chatbot, and you can start a conversation with them for any topic, and the model will be answering accordingly. The same that you are doing with ChatGPT. You can do that for a general topic, or you can use as well the chat for code. No, here we have a version that specializes in code generation. Let's check you high. And to generate a function to extract a PDF, no, text from a PDF. Let's check that. Yeah, can you write unit test okay? But in here you can continue as much as you want with that. It's yeah. That's a unit test, test case. Yeah, well, it's set as a true. Yeah, it's a, well, it's a, not bad, eh? Again, it's a, at least a beginning to start with many things. You can get something done pretty quickly, eh? For those that are starting in a language. I definitely use in some cases, eh? So in especially when I had to work with code in, for example, in TypeScript or Node, that I'm not really fluent on those, I just ask and then have to see to understand if something is really complicated to understand or simply I'm lazy, I don't want to find it in internet, no? But yeah, to start with is not bad. This part of unit test is quite boring many times to create unit tests from you spend many time doing the test. But yeah, you can take a look as well at your convenience. It's quite interesting. And also here the translate, no? Translate is, well, typical translation. Yeah, it's if you remember Whisper in OpenAI, well, similar to what Whisper is doing. Well, here Whisper is more. We had a better version here. This is, yeah, in OpenAI, Whisper is on the section of the speech models, not in translation. You can do a translation. It's true. You can just pass an audio with in Russian, for example, or in Spanish, and then on you can do not only transcribe the audio, also you can translate. But yeah, well, here you have the different options from different languages, and depending on the language that you use, Italian to only English. Well, not and if we use English, we had options to export. Yeah, it's strange that you cannot, for example, translate from French only to English. Literally the same. Okay. Then you can upload here also examples if you want to do a few soft prompting. It's not just to give the model a reference. Yeah, you can do it as well. As I said before, the maximum amount, or sea, the biggest file is 7 megabits or under. You can import multiple files. It's not you have to use a bucket for files that are longer than 7 megabytes. But also, depending on the model that you are using, you will exceed, depending on how big is the model, you will exceed the context window. Then you may have an error or receive an error of quotas exceed. In my prompts, you have every prompt that you save in one of these options is saved on your section My Prompts. You can create it as well directly here and later on use it. And you can also use it, use them programmatically. And tune and steer, this is what I will show in the next video, is I just fine-tune a model for text classification. The base foundational model is the Gemini Pro, and it's just specialized on doing text classification. I doubt that the model even need to do this, but well, I will show you later in the next video how to do the fine-tuning, how to prepare the data set, and also how to deploy the model to an endpoint. Okay, so next, let's move to the Jupyter Notebook. Again, I will later upload the Jupyter Notebook to the repository, and I will patch you the link. So we import the libraries we need. I will post later as well. We only need a library here. The main library is the Vertex Cloud ID, Vertex AI Cloud ID, Cloud Library. I will pass you later a reference of the library, name to you later if you want to use it in local, install it in local with PIP. So we import the libraries we need, we import the credentials, we log into the system, we create using the service account. The service account is just a JSON file, you can see here, that you generate on Google Cloud, and you download to local, and then you initialize the access to the API. Here we are just, this example is just a few short prompting for model, text labeling. So we had four options. Bueno, four, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight options, eight labels, and then we pass some examples, and we just ask the model to label a text according to the categories we have here, no? And then on the model is producing text health and fitness. You can check later, change this, and then obviously the model is going to restrict the answer to the options that you have here in the prompt. The second example is just a sentimental analysis. It's just zero shot prompting. Yeah, simply we just create, well, to create this function, you just create a generation config, maximum number of tokens. The same option that you define in the UI, you have it here, the temperature of P1. Safety settings, again, you can here decide which level you want to use. Either have low and above, medium and above, known, or only high. We had the four sections, and the four sections, if you don't send anything, you receive an error, so you have to specify the safety settings, the model, and generate content. You pass the text, a list of text, and generation config, safety setting, and here just a string equal true, but here we are just transforming the string into a single text. We pass the text and generate a sentiment of the review and explain the reasoning why you decide that, no? Why the model decide that. Yeah, exactly. Here we have the COT examples. If you watch my channel, if you are following my channel, you may see that I upload some experiments using Llama 2 7 billions, Mistral 7 billions as well, and Llama 3 8 billions. All of them with a number of problems, of COT problems, and well, we see how the models behave in these on these problems, which are the probably the most difficult, no, to solve these mathematical questions, a question that you need to follow a rational, with there are some logic problems as well. There is also specialized data set to fine-tune the models just according to these tags, no, to specialize in these tags. We did some examples with the three models I mentioned you before, with the Llama 2, 7 billion, with the Mistral 7 billion, and with Llama 3, 8 billion, and then we test after the training, before and after the training, the models versus the four or five questions I will show you here as well. No? So we have here this first problem that is provide the sum up of the numbers in this list. Here, well, is 852. So you have to just sum up these two numbers. The answer is correct. Here is the problem of the sister. When I was six, my sister was half of my age. Now I'm 17. How old is my sister? Obviously, it's 67. I ask in the model to get a rational of how is answering the problem. Here, the problem of these apples. I bought 10 apples. I give 2 to the neighbor, 2 to the repairman. Then again, I went to the to buy five more, and also I ate one, and then on how many I have, and then on in total 10 again. The rational is correct. Then on these problems with many of the models fails, also Gemini Pro 001, the previous version of the model I'm using today, fails as well. Today, as you can see here, is providing the first answer wrong, but later on the rational is calculating correctly. I had the table I prepared for these experiments in Llama. Mistral is also in the repository. You can take a look here. Mistral, COT fine tuning. So here in Mistral, we had this Llama Struth Colora COT, and we have the table which is doing the calculation of the car depreciation. Come on, at the all. So the problem is essentially we had a car. The car, where is? I bought a car 20 years ago and it costs 100,000. The car annual depreciation is 5%. Using the percent and the cleaning balance method, what is the value of the car now? And then on, yeah, this is the table. It's a medium complex, no, tax, no, which is you need to do some calculations. The problem, well, I will say that it's not simple even for many human beings, but well, it was just a test, no. And then here, Llama 3 calculated correctly. No, it was not correct. It was also not correct. Yeah, it's Llama 3 didn't calculate it correctly. Yeah, so not correct. And here, Vertex, where I have, sorry, here, calculated correctly, completely correctly. But consider that, yeah, this model is, how to say, this model contains practically 1.7 trillion tokens in comparison with Llama 3, 8 billion. Well, it's 200 times bigger or more, almost 200 times bigger in terms of size. No? And then if we compare the model Llama 3, 8 billion is free, this model is not free. And also the size and the prediction power or generative power of both models, yeah, I think we cannot compare them that easy. No? In any case, that's another topic. With Gemini, with this version of Gemini, is working fine. Again, when I did this test 4 months ago, it didn't work. It fails the answer. So today fine. It's answered correctly. Here, the last problem, this in total was five different problems. I'm not answering here. Let's think step by step. Correct. Here, just a pretty simple problem. 20 years ago, I had a car. At that time, I was 37. How old am I now? Obviously, 57. And the latest example is just a summary, provide a few short prompting as well with the Pro002, and just provide some examples and provide a summary of the following text. Well, that's all. Pretty interesting stuff. Again, the models have been improved a lot from version 001. It's a big step forward. Also, surprised with the how easy it is to manage the UI and to start to work with the models and to generate something very quickly. Very good stuff, what they did, Google. Again, 4 months ago, it was a little bit primitive. Many things were not working, but the outputs were a little bit disappointing. Now it's much, much better. The test that we had been done with the multimodal model with the version 1.5 had been very, very good. It's really impressive. Just waiting today release the final version of 1.5 because yeah, it's gonna be a problem challenger, a problem solver, no? And yeah, well, that's all. Again, a lot of very interesting stuff in just in the UI in the studio, eh? And you can take a look to the examples. Also, again, you will have the chance to cover this material I will post later on in your local environment. If you just follow the instructions and you can start to play with either with the notebook via Python SDK, or you can play simply here on the studio and start to be familiar with the models and what they are able to do. And for those that have been working with the other providers like OpenAI or Anthropic, this is going to be very simple for you. You will understand all the very quickly the interface and everything. Very, very simple and very, very easy to use for you. And again, many tutorials, how to do many things, no? And again, a lot of examples. You can take a look. This one is pretty simple. You just open the prompt and run it. You can change it. You say, for example, here, finance table summarization. Yeah, it's pretty impressive what it's doing. Then you can get examples of what to do here. Then, if you want to code something, take the code. You just reformat this and apply. And yeah. Again, many of this stuff is gonna work only here or in a notebook in Vertex AI, but you can refactor this with not a very big effort and do something, start to prepare an application very quickly and even show to the users or the stakeholders how this works and what is possible to be done with this. Okay, that's all. Thank you very much for watching. Give me a like if you like the content of the video and you find it interesting and useful for your training or for your job, whatever, doesn't matter. And well, give me a like, subscribe to the channel if you didn't do it before, and share the content if you consider that is also interesting for others that probably are interesting colleagues or friends or whoever. Thank you. Okay, thank you. Thank you very much. Bye bye.